Defence analyst Oubai Shahbandar now. Oubai, I just want to point out now the foreign ministry from Iran has come out and said that steps to decrease its commitment to the deal are reversible and has again urged Europe to step up efforts to salvage the deal. Explain to us why we're seeing this. On the one hand, it's saying, oh, we've exceeded our limits. On the other hand, it's saying, but we could go back and make things right.
Well, this is a big gamble by Iran's Supreme Leader Ayatollah Ali Khamenei. It's coming at a time when international sanctions that have been led by the Trump administration are really taking a toll on Iran's economy. Its oil exports have been halved. The European Union and the member states that were part of the nuclear deal with Iran have complied with the Trump administration's maximum pressure campaign. And that's really put Iran in a very tough place and put the government in Tehran in a very difficult position. This is probably an effort by Khamenei to remain relevant, to add some sort of leverage, to put pressure on the European Union. Iran desperately wants to do business with the EU. It wants to export its oil. It wants to circumvent the sanctions that Washington has implemented. Remember, it's also, it was just in May that the Trump administration ended all waivers for trading with Iran. And with oil exports at 50% of what they once were, we can definitely look at the leadership in Tehran to look for a way out. This is just another attempt by Tehran to gain leverage, but it may lead to an escalatory response by Washington. And let's also remember the EU thus far has so far complied with the Trump administration's maximum pressure campaign. So a very big gamble here by Tehran that we're seeing.
How is Washington likely to respond then? Because as you said, the strategy has been maximum pressure.
Well, we cannot de-link the nuclear deal and the ongoing controversy with Iran's nuclear program with the ongoing tensions in the Arabian Gulf. Remember, this is a time when the U.S. has added an aircraft carrier strike group in the region. This is right after the U.S. drone was shot down and six tankers were hit in the Arabian Gulf. That's been linked back to the Iranian Revolutionary Guards. And with Iran active militarily in Iraq, Syria and Lebanon and the Arabian Gulf. So it's an effort also by what we've heard from the Trump administration that they want to counter what they call Iran's malign influence and destabilizing activity in the region. The Trump administration pulled out of the deal because they believed it was not equitable, that they believed that Iran was getting much more than the U.S. was getting in terms of guarantees that Iran would not eventually pursue a nuclear program and nuclear weaponization program. So right now we can look at Washington to continue its maximum pressure campaign. Iran will gradually probably increase its pressure and its enrichment in terms of its uranium and heavy water reactor production in an effort to try to get the Europeans to break off from the Americans. But with the Trump administration so far, it doesn't seem to be in any mood to come back to the negotiating table. They want Ali Khamenei, they want the supreme leader of Iran and Tehran's leadership to come back, renegotiate the deal that is at a much bigger advantage to the United States and to its regional allies. And so far, Tehran does not seem to be in any mood to do that.
We should also point out, as Ali John mentioned in his package, that in terms of the levels of enriched uranium, a power plant needs between 3% and 5%. The agreed cap was 3.67%. But in order to create nuclear weapons, you need 80-90% enriched uranium. So we are a way off that.
We are way off from that. So it's there's no need for alarm bells right now. It doesn't mean that Iran is rushing to a nuclearization, a weaponization effort. But Iran does have the know-how. It does have the facilities. It does have the ability to quickly produce these advanced centrifuges that could go quickly from 10%, 20% to 90%. And it wants Washington to know that.
Because it's cumulative. We will have to leave it there. Thank you so much for that. That's Oubai Shahbandar.